हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द फोर्थ यूनिट ऑफ द मॉड्यूल फूड पैकेजिंग एंड लेबलिंग एंड द टाइटल ऑफ द यूनिट इज पैकेजिंग मटेरियल। सो अंडर द हेडिंग ऑफ पैकेजिंग मटेरियल देर आर फोर सब पार्ट। फर्स्ट वी नीड टू टॉक अबाउट द पेपर बेस्ड पैकेजिंग मटेरियल, देन वी विल कवर मेटल पैकेजिंग मटेरियल, ग्लास पैकेजिंग मटेरियल एंड एट लास्ट वी विल टॉक अबाउट फूड पैकेजिंग क्लोजर्स एंड सीलिंग सिस्टम्स। सो इन टुडे लेक्चर आई विल टॉक अबाउट ओनली वन पार्ट, दैट इज पेपर बेस्ड पैकेजिंग मटेरियल। सो इफ वी टॉक अबाउट द वर्ड पेपर, the word paper has been derived from the Egyptian word papyrus or papyro. So because the first paper was developed by Egyptian and they developed the paper from the plant papyrus, so that's why this terms has been given to the paper, that is paper. So it was not a scientific method, and the actual credit goes to a Chinese administrator. His name was Sai Sun, and he developed the paper in China in 105 AD. So from China it was taken to the Tibet, and from Tibet it was taken to the Japan, and from the Japan in 1751 the Chinese lose the war against the Mughals, or you can say Islamics or the Mohammedans. So after the getting defeat, the Chinese were getting prisons, and these Muslim emperors take the art or kidnap the persons, those who were learned or those who were familiar to how to make a paper. So in this way it spread in the Muslim world, and from the Muslim world it was taken to the Moors, and then it was taken to Germany and Spain. So when it comes to Europe, then there are the two countries, they claim that they are the first one to start the paper manufacturing. From Germany it goes to England, but in England it was not feasible, so finally it was shifted to the Sweden, and later on it was introduced in USA. So approximately 10% of all paper and paper boards, there are two terms, paper and paper board consumption, is used for packagings. There are number of application of paper. Some people use paper for the writings, in case of decorations, number of applications are there, but out of the total production 10% is used for packaging, and out of this total 10%, 50% of this 10% is used for the food industry. So paper and paper based material are oldest and most versatile packaging materials. If we talk about the history, they can be permanent or temporary, gentle or strong, cheap or expensive in plenty or limited. For example, if it is a homemade paper, then it will be very costly and it will be very limited amount, and if it is industrial paper, it will be available in the plenty amount, and the cost will not be that high. Paper and board alone or associated with other material has been used in food packaging or food contact for many years. As we know, the paper is not a good barrier of water vapors and some gases. So in most of the packaging, paper is associated, or you can say coupled, with any another packaging material like polyethylene, and then it is used for the food packaging. So paper and board is indeed an essential part of our life and satisfy many human needs. What are the human needs, or you can say daily life requirement? This paper is used to store and communicate informations like newspaper, books, documents, writing paper for cultural and artistic purpose, to transport and protect the goods, packaging sacks, liquid packaging boards, or for personal hygiene like tissues, napkin and nappies. So this is the picture in which there is a folding boards. Here it is a artistic work. Here it is the notebook, and here it has been shown there is a tissue. So there are wide application of the paper. So if we talk about what paper is exactly, paper is made from the cellulose fiber, which are obtained from tree. recovered paper and annual plant fibers like cereal straws. So the cellulose can be obtained from three sources: from tree, from recovered paper, and the plant fiber like cereal straws. Today, about 97% of the world paper and the board is made from the wood pulp, and out of this wood pulp, 85% is the softwood. And the softwood comes from these trees: spruces, firs, and pines. So if we talk about what is the difference between the pulp, or you can say the paper that we obtain from softwood and hardwood, the length of the polymer or the cellulose polymer is bit higher than hardwood. The length of the polymer that is obtained from softwood is longer than the cellulose that is obtained from the hardwood. Generally, it ranges from 1 to 5 and it ranges to 3 to 4.5. So, in generally, it is said that it is 2.5 to 3 times higher than this hardwood polymer, or longer than hardwood polymer. So, these are the some trees which are generally, or you can say commercially, used for the production of paper: scotch pine, larch, spruce, fir, and pines. So, as I said, paper is made from the cellulose. So, what is there in the cellulose that make it perfect or suitable for the paper making? Cellulose consists of long ribbon-like molecule made up of small glucose unit. It is a long and ribbon-like molecule made up of small glucose unit, and these glucose units are formed of atoms, carbon, hydrogen, and oxygens. These molecules are held together side by side by the hydrogen bond to form sheet, which in turn are piled together in a tightly packed layer to form microfibrils. Mean to say that cellulose layers piled up and make a microfibrils, and then later these microfibrils piled up together in a bundle and they form a paper fiber. Fine. Paper is called board when it's heavier than 224 gram per meter square. So this is an experiment we supposed to carry out. So if the weight of the paper is more than 224 gram per meter square, then we will say it as a paper board. So here it is the structure of the cellulose. So you can see here. So this is the chain of the cellulose, and this is the another chain of the cellulose. So in between these cellulose layers, there is a possibility of hydrogen linking. And due to this hydrogen linking, this cellulose is available in form of a sheet. So this sheet ultimately forms this microfibrils, firs, pines, conifer trees. From this soft wood, we take the wood, and this wood, in the wood there is a cell wall, and that cell wall is composed of 40 to 40% cellulose, around 25 to 29% hemicellulose, and it is lignin, 25 to 31%. So out of these three constituents, the cellulose is the desirable one, and this lignin is not desirable one. Hemicellulose does not contribute much to the paper making. So in the process of paper making, the wood is converted finally into a pulp. Wood is converted into pulp, and during the pulping procedure, the processors used to remove the lignin content, because the cellulose and hemicellulose are white, and the color of the paper or that pulp is due to the your lignin content. If we talk about the fresh pulp, so how we proceed when we start the paper making? First of all, we take the wood, and then we remove the bark. After removing the bark, this wood logs is converted into chips by pressing the logs on a grindstones. So you might have seen in the video. Now these due to grindstones, when we press the logs on the grindstone, there is a heat generations, and due to heat generations, that wood gets softens, and we obtain a pulp, and that is known as mechanical pulp, in which we can add bit of water, but we do not any kind of chemical, and this is the mechanical pulp. There can be another type of pulp that is known as chemical pulp, there can be another type of pulp in which we carry out heating, that is the thermal type of the pulp, and there can be another method in which we can use mechanical as well as chemical methods, and that will be known as chemi-mechanical process. So these are the four processes by which we can obtain the pulp from the wood. So mechanical pulp is in larger quantity because it also contains the lignin, but the paper quality that will be produced from the mechanical pulp will be very poor because it contains lignin, and lignin will impart a color, as well as the strength of the paper will not be that good. Fine. So when we process the mechanical pulp, we add some bleaching agent to reduce or to improve the color. So bleaching agent that we add in the pulp are of two type, either it will be oxidative type or it will be reductive type. If it is oxidative type, then we will add hydrogen peroxide or sodium hypochlorite. Other than this, we can use a reductive type of bleaching agent, that will be your hydrosulfide. Fine. In case of chemical pulp is simply we take the wood chips and then we use to boil them in a sodium hydroxide solutions having concentration of 4 to 6%, and we heat it up to 170 degree centigrade, and the pulp thus obtained is known as chemical pulp. This chemical pulp is further treated with sulfate and sulfite just to make it more soluble and to remove the impurities. So after pulping, the next step is the stock preparation. Either it is a mechanical pulp or a chemical pulp. These two are the dominating pulp in the industry. Either the industry use mechanical pulp or the chemical pulp. There is a stock preparation, and it is simply a hydration process in which excess of water is added for the hydration of cellulose fiber, and after that this stock is passed to the paper making machine. Fine. And if we talk about the paper making machine, this the oldest machine and is the Fourdriner, Fourdriner, Fourdriner machines, and the name of the machine was given on the basis of there were the two sponsor, you can say financier, there were the two brothers, and they were financing this project. And initially what happens, the people used to manufacturing the paper, but they were not able to make it long sheet of the paper. They make the paper in the pieces. So they tried a lot and put all efforts, and even they were bankrupted. Finally they die in the very miserable and very, they face, you can say, a high level of poverty at the end. But they have contributed a lot, all for the all money for the development of this machine, and finally this machine was developed. And in honor of those two brothers, the financier brothers, this name was given. So more or less maximum today also the most of the machines are working on this pattern. There may be little modifications. So before going to this Fourdriner machines, I'll brief you about some other important information, that the first machine to manufacture the paper continuously was invented by Frenchman Nicolas Robert in 1799 for writing and printing purpose. Raw material composition, that is mixture of chemicals, softwood and hardwood, mechanical pulp, recovered paper, filler pigment, additives, etc. Machine size, type of production equipment, automation levels. So these are the factors that decide the efficiency of the machines. All the paper and the board machines are based on similar basic process. As I said, there are 7 distinct sections in that for linear machines: head box, wire sections, press section, dryer section, size press, calendar and relay. Fine. So when I was describing here the pulping, so this is the case when we are producing the paper from the fresh pulp. So this is the fresh pulp. There can be another possibility that if we are recycling the paper, then I'll talk about that one also. So this is the basic setup of the machine, and he is the person. So here it is a diagrammatic representation that how we produce the mechanical pulp. These are the wood, washed wood chips, and in the mechanical refiner, then we go for cleaning, and the pulp thus obtained will be mechanical pulp. In case of chemical pulp, this is the raw stock, and then it is you can say fed into a digester in which there is NaOH, and we heat it at a high temperature. And the purpose of this heating is to remove the lignin. So this black color is indicating that we are removing the lignin. Then some pre-bleaching with oxygen delignification is carried out, and finally means we carry out pre-bleaching, washing, and finally we obtain the pulp, and that pulp is known as your chemical pulp. There can be another possibility in which we are recycling the newspaper. In recycling of newspaper, the problem is that there is a ink, and we used to remove the ink, and in this we used to feed it in a kind of hydropulper fiber separations, and by centrifugations we can remove the ink, and the pulp thus obtained will be recycled pulp. So if you will mix this ink, this recycled pulp with that mechanical pulp, then it will give you a gray shade. And if you are using simply mechanical pulp, then it will be a brown shade. So this is the first part of that machine that I was describing. There is a head box in which there is a fiber suspension. Down there is a open-ended wire mesh. Here you can see there is a wire mesh. And this wire mesh can be made up of very finely wound stainless steel, or it can be made up of plastics threads also. So this is the Stokes solutions, and we are transferring the fibers. Okay, and when we transfer the fiber on this particular wire mesh, then they make a sheet. Fine, and there is a drainage of water. And the paper that will be obtained from the single layer of this paper will be used for the manufacturing of tissue paper and napkin. If we are preparing some paper board, heavy duty paper board, then we have to make multi layers. Means we will make a provision of sheet over sheet. And then we will press it, and then we will give a thickness. Then only the weight will increase. So after making this is the sheeting procedures in which the fibers align themselves, and the fibers that is aligning themselves, that is known as the machine direction, and the right angle is known as cross directions. So here is the basic step or the pictorial representation of paper making. As I said, first of all we will take the pulp, then pulp will be transferred in a Stokes solutions. So in the Stokes solutions we will add more water, fine, and then we will add some sizing agent, then we will transfer it into the head box. So when the material which is coming out from the head box, it is containing only 2% fiber and around 98% water. So there is a wire mesh, and due to the wire mesh, the water gets drained, or there can be a provision of vacuum under this screen that suck the water and it reduce the moisture content. Then it is passed to the two rolls, and from here the paper that is available here on this wire mesh, his moisture content has reduced to 60%, from 98 to 60%. After that, it is passed through these are the steam heated rollers. So this is known as the drying sections. When the paper sheet is moved on these steam heated drums, then there is a further reduction in the moisture content, and finally the moisture content of the paper remains less than 10%. After this, it is passed through the calendaring, and then there is a coating. So in case of calendaring is again a type of heating process, and then coating. In case of coating, china clay or calcium carbonate is coated on the both side of the surface, both side of the paper, and the purpose is to give a extra strength and whiteness and smoothness to the paper, and finally it is relung. So this is the basic process of paper making. Here it is another pictorial representation. You can see these are the trees. From the trees we have taken wood, and these wood are debarking drums. In the debarking drums we have removed the outer bark, and then they were converted into chips. These chips were thermomechanically refined, then the paper was manufactured, paper making, and this is the crude form or the very low quality paper. And the very low quality paper is used for the newspaper and the any printing materials. Fine. So otherwise we can use this low quality pulp or low quality paper for the manufacturing of board also. Then it is used, collected, and after collections it is again converted into pulp, and in the process of pulping we use the adopt a step of de-inking. After de-inking it is cleaning and fine screening, and further it is thermomechanically recycled pulp we have obtained. And another further we will make a fresh paper. So this recycling has played a great role. If recycling is not been done, then there can be a lot of deforestations. So this is a bless, you can say, for the paper industry. There can be the first problem, that deforestation may take place. Second, there will be a lot of solid waste, and there will be a lot of landfill with the waste of this paper, manufactured paper. So here it is the same thing that I was explaining, that first of all tree was taken, barking was carried out, chipping was done, then it can be done chemical pulping or waste paper pulping. Fine. After that it is all are fed to the stock preparations depending on our requirement. If we are preparing a bleached paper, then we will take only chemical pulp. If we are preparing the paper board, then we will take only mechanical pulp. And if we are preparing the newspaper, then we will take only this waste paper. So generally the strength of this waste paper pulp is not that good. So for the production or for commercial use, it is always mixed with the fresh pulp that is obtained by the mechanical pulping. So here it is a stock preparation. After stock preparation, that is a sheeting, that is known as forming. Then we carry out pressing, then we carry out drying, and finally you obtain the paper. Fine. So here it is again that same thing. I have shown you 4-5 pics, but the same procedure. Here it is pulp, it is head box, it is releasing the material. Here there can be 2-3 machines. See, there can be 2 wire sections, a cylinder machines, a frontier machines. So that depends on the requirement. So the procedure will be remain same. The water will be, the fiber, hydrated fiber will be released on the belt. It will drain the water, and now this is entered in a roll, or you can say this film is passing under a roll. It will press it. Due to pressing, further water removal will take place. Then we can say then it will enter in the dry sections. In the dry sections, after passing through the dry sections, we do the sizing and coating, and finally your paper will be reeled up or sheeted. Reel means we will make a kind of bundle, that is reeling up, and sheeted means we will cut the paper into pieces. So there are different type of paper. First one is the craft paper, and this is typically a coarse paper with exceptional strength and often made up of a fold dryer machine, and then either machine glazed or a Yankee dryer machine finished on a calendar. It is sometimes made with no calendaring, so that when it is converted into bag, the rough surface will prevent them from sliding over each another. So this craft paper is generally used for the manufacturing of corrugated paper board. You might have seen the video. In case of craft paper, we can use the craft paper for the paper bags also. Fine. So in case of corrugated board, you have seen that we used the 3 layer. There are the 2 outer layer and 1 is the sandwich layer. So the two outer layer is made up of softwood and the one inner layer is made up of hardwood. So there is a glue roll, there is a there is a roll in which on which you are this the paper from the softwood is moving, and then we press this hardwood paper on that this softwood paper. That also in the video, don't worry. Bleached paper, it is very good quality paper, and as much as it is bleached, it will be very white. So there are manufactured from the pulp which are relatively white, bright and soft, receptive to small chemicals necessary to develop many functional properties. They are generally more expensive and weaker than the unbleached paper, and their aesthetic appeal is frequently improved by clay coating on one or both sides. Then this is the grease proof paper, and this is translucent machine finished paper which has been hydrated to give oil grease resistance. Then glassine paper, it is produced by further treating the grease proof paper in a super colander where it is carefully dampened with the water and run through a set of steam heated roller. This result in such intimate inter fiber hydrogen bonding that refractive index of the glassine paper approaches to 1.02 value of the amorphous cellulose, indicating that very few pores on or other fiber air interfaces exit on the scattering light or allowing the liquid penetrations. So it is a further modification of your grease proof paper. So vegetable parchment papers, basically it is used as a sandwich. It involves passing a web of high quality unsized chemical pulp through a batch of concentrated sulfuric acid. Cellulosic fibers swell and partially dissolve, filling the space between the fibers and resulting in extensive hydrogen bonding through washing in water followed by drying on the conventional paper making dryers. So these are the example of muffins, and the paper that we use for the coating of muffins is the vegetable parchment paper. Parchment is actually something that is refers to the animal skins. So when it was invented, paper was invented. So firstly, the paper was invented from the papyrus, but the papyrus was not available all over the world. It was available on the bank of the Nile rivers. So animals were everywhere. So the animal skin was used as a writing medium. So they used to strengthen or elongate the animal skin, and then they make it as a writing medium, or else they use it as an alternate of the paper. So that is known as parchment, and it is same like parchment paper. So it is a bare, as it is dissolved in the sulfuric acid, so all of the cellulose gets swells and the space doesn't remain void. So it fills the space and it doesn't allow the leakage of the some waxy materials. There may be a leakage, but not to that extent. Waxed paper provides a barrier against the penetration of liquid and vapor, and the wet waxed paper have a continuous surface film on both sides. So this is all about in the slides. I'll resume for some time, then I'll show you the paper.
Let's look at how paperboard is manufactured.
I have uploaded this video, but you can see
trucks load logs of harvested trees into a debarking drum where they're stripped of their bark. From there, they're fed into a chipper. The logs are cut into small chips, which are then, for quality reasons, screened to remove unwanted sizes. The result is perfect wood chips, the best start for the pulp making process. The chips are refined into individual fibers. The fibers are washed and bleached in a multiple stage process. This process produces pulp that is clean and white to the highest.
Anyway, let me resume it once. Yeah, student, you can watch on the Really, I have uploaded that video. I am not able to find it. Okay, thank you very much. In the next class, I'll talk about metal and glass.